be put to death.
That's right.
Give a hand. Give a hand. It shall surely be put to death.
That's right. That's right. Now we're gonna get Muslim on the scene.
Yeah.
Put him to death.
Here we go. That's what we talk about. That it shall surely be put to death. Let's get the most out of here, man. It shall surely be put to death. It shall surely be put to death. Now, was that nice?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Keep me out of the community.
No.
Come on, man. Let's get the most out of here. Get the most out of here, man. So about this, bro. I'm gonna take it off, man.
Wow, that was powerful, man. That was powerful. Yeah, so we're closing out later tonight, so I'm not going to take too much of your time. Thank everybody for coming out here, sitting out through it. I know it was a long roller coaster ride, ups and downs and everything, right? But every time we do it, we try to do it big, and we can't do it without the help from everybody coming out here to actually support this event. So we want to thank all of Israel for coming together and supporting this event. So give yourselves a round right here. Give yourselves a round right here. All right, so now I got to be a good cop. You just had the bad cop on stage. All right, so I'm going to end this off on something that's very interesting. I need a female to come up here. Who's going to be brave enough to come up here? I would pick you, but you're too young. Maybe another 5 years. A female, any female that's brave enough to come up here? Wow, okay. I hope I ain't got to pick nobody. Who wants to volunteer? Okay, awesome, awesome. Give her a hand, y'all. I'm asking you a question. Are you familiar with the Bible? Okay, that's all right. I'm gonna help you out. Have a seat right here if you don't mind. Matter of fact, let me pull the chair out for you.
Aw, that's a gentleman.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
I know there's a lot of women in here who may be single, some of y'all may not. Where the single women at? Raise your hand. Single women. That's it? Man, Israel was good with grabbing these rubies, man, I'm telling you. All right. Well, this message can go out for the single women out there that may be watching this video. The question is here is, it says, who can find a virtuous woman? Who can find a virtuous woman, right? That's what the text says. Who can find? But how are you to find this virtuous woman? Is the woman supposed to be doing something to be found? Or is she supposed to be sitting around waiting for the man to come and get her? Which one of y'all think it is? Any of y'all?
Gotta be doing something, right?
All right, y'all don't believe. Let's go to the precepts in the text. Can you just read here and I'll tell you when to stop? All right, I'm just gonna have her to read. Y'all should be familiar with this text right here, but I'm gonna let her read. Yeah, it says,
and Naomi had a kinsman of her husband's, a mighty man of wealth, of the family of Elimelech.
Uh-huh, keep going.
And his name was Boaz.
Boaz.
Woo!
I know y'all know this story, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Come on, y'all. All right, keep going.
And Ruth the Moabite said unto Naomi,
wait,
what?
Now, just so y'all can get some backdrop, right? Naomi had two sons. Mm-hmm. The two sons were married to two women. She also had a husband. Her husband died, and then the two sons died. Now, the two daughter-in-laws were sticking with her. One of the daughter-in-laws she sent away, and she also attempted to send Ruth away. But Ruth said, no, I'm not going to leave you, and she served there for about 10 years.
Right.
So this is the backdrop. So now, an individual by the name of Boaz came along, who was a kinsman to a husband that passed, or a close relative. Israelite, my apologies. And now she goes to Naomi because she spotted Boaz. So now it's the process, y'all. She didn't just go run up to him. She didn't just sit there and wait. She went to an elder woman. And what did she do? Keep reading, sis.
Let me go now to the field and glean ears of corn after him, in whose sight I shall find grace.
Slow down. So now she said to the elder woman. Now, young women, y'all should be going to the elder woman when you spot a man who you think is fit for marriage.
That's
this
right.
Is order. Are y'all feeling me in here? This is very, very important because they have wisdom. And you must trust that wisdom that's in them. So she went to Naomi and said, hey, yo, I seen this guy, I really like him. What do you think I should do? So Naomi gave her advice on what to do. Because she wanted to go and be around him so she can be noticed. But slow down. She said she wanted to work around him so she can be noticed. She didn't just sit down and wait. He wasn't going actively looking for her. Because he was on his grind. Now she wanted to be on her grind as well. This is very important, y'all. Keep reading.
And she said unto her, go, my daughter.
So she gave her permission. Keep going.
And she went and came and gleaned in the field.
So she worked in the field. Uh-huh. Keep going.
And her hap was to light on a part of the field belonging unto Boaz.
Uh-huh. So now she worked in the area where Boaz had property. Keep going.
And who was the kindred of Elimelech.
Okay. Keep going.
And behold, Boaz came from Bethlehem and said unto the reapers,
what did he say?
The Lord be with you. And they answered him, the Lord bless thee.
Okay, so it's a greeting. Keep going.
And then said Boaz unto his servant that was set over the reapers, whose damsel is this?
Whose damsel is this? So now she put herself in a situation where she was working hard so he can see the quality of her character. And he noticed her. Interesting. Keep going.
And the servant that was sent over the reapers answered and said, it is the
Moabitish damsel
that came back with Naomi out of the country.
So now people hear the report of who this woman is. Keep going.
And she said, I pray you, let me glean and gather after the reapers among the sheaves.
So now she's speaking to him and said, listen, let me just work here. Keep going.
So she came and hath continued even from the morning until now, and she tarried a little in the house.
Okay. Now, which scripture did you end off at? Where you at? What verse?
10:04.
What, right here? Okay, keep reading.
Then said Boaz unto Ruth, hearest thou not my daughter? Go not to glean in another field, neither go from hence, but abide here fast by my maidens.
Uh-huh. So now he's giving her instruction. Keep reading.
Let thine eyes be on the field that they do reap.
Let your eyes be what? On the field. See how you was handling her? Let your eyes be on your work. Because we need to, gotcha. We need to test the quality of your character. Keep going.
Let your eyes be on the field they do reap, and go thou after them. Have I not charged the young men that they shall not touch thee?
Now, keep going. The young men not touch you in the field. Keep going.
And when thou art athirst, go unto the vessels and drink of that which the young men.
So what he's doing is he's testing her character to see how she harkens into his instructions, right? Mm-hmm. This is very important, because I'm going to get to the climax in a moment. I only got a couple of minutes. Okay, read the next verse, and then we're going to jump to climax. Can you read the next verse?
Then she fell on her face and bowed herself to the ground and said unto him, why have I found grace in thine eyes that thou shouldest take knowledge of me, seeing I am a stranger?
Saying that I am a stranger. Okay, keep going.
And Boaz answered and said unto her, it hath fully been showed me all that thou hast done unto thy mother.
Now he's repeating to her the report that he received about her character, her diligence, and her work. This is very, very important, because your reputation speaks volumes to young women. Not looking for a man, but what are you doing and who are you serving under? See? This is very, very important. You can read the rest of that.
And that was answered. All that thou hast done unto thy mother-in-law since the death of thine husband, and how thou hast left thy father and thy mother, and the land of thy nativity, and art come unto a people which thou knewest not heretofore.
All right, you can stop here. So now I'm going to get to the last verse, and then I'm going to wrap this up. Okay, so we're going to go here, jump to, we go to verse 8. Okay, before you read that. Now, a lot of us are familiar with the text that said a man that findeth a wife, findeth a good thing, and does what afterwards? Obtains what? Favor from Yah. Obtains favor. This is very, very important. All right, you can read verse 8 and I'll tell you when to stop.
And it came to pass at midnight that the man was afraid and turned himself, and behold, a woman lay at his feet. Mm-hmm. And he said, who art thou? And she answered, I am Ruth, thine handmaid. Spread therefore thy skirt over thine handmaid, for thou art a near kinsman.
Okay, now, that has to do with the laws of the Torah. We'll get into that. Pay attention to this verse here. Keep going.
And he said, blessed be thou of the Lord, my daughter, for thou hast showed more kindness in the latter end than at the beginning.
Keep going.
And so much as thou followest not young men, whether
they follow young men, neither poor nor rich, so she wasn't gold digging, and then she wasn't just looking for any old body. Keep going.
And now, my daughter, fear not, I will do thee all that thou request. For all the city of my people doth know that thou art a virtuous.
All the people of my city doth know that you're a what? Say again.
Virtuous woman.
A virtuous woman.
Matriarch.
Chayel. Why is this important? This is very important because nowadays there's no order, no structure in courtship. And now we have women that out there that think that they're owed a husband, but yet they have not put in that work. Mm-hmm. There's no reputation in the land about how they're conducting their character. This is very important. The reason why Boaz was shocked, not because she showed up, but because the instruction that was given to Ruth that she followed had to come from somebody that had wisdom, somebody that was much older. How many elders do we have overseeing our courtship process? How many? The reason why this is important, because in order for a woman to be virtuous, you have to be on your grind, serving and working, so that way you can be noticed by him, so he can find you. Because if you want to stand out and be that ruby amongst all the other rocks or anything else that's there, something must be done so that he can notice you. Are y'all following me? I know it's late, I know you're getting tired, but I want you to leave off with this message, because we had a panel discussion on polygamy. right? Panis because you don't believe me. And we had several information that came up from several speakers on tonight. What I'm going to leave off today is that in order for us to go in a righteous direction in courting each other, and for the women out there, the young single women that's out there that's looking for a husband, and you want to be found by a husband, a good report about you has to be out there in the land. You must be working. You must show your servitude. Somebody has to understand that you're able to take care of the home. In Proverbs 31, the virtuous wife, because even though it's Isha, if you look, it says her husband in the next verse. The reason why he chose her is because in his absence, she was grinding. Mm-hmm. Now, he had to have seen this trait or characteristic in her before he married her.
Right.
Are y'all feeling me? Mm-hmm. This is very, very important because we need order, we need structure in our courtship process. And if a woman wants to be identified by the right man, she needs to be on her grind so that way he can notice her and then he can do things based on order. So I'm just going to leave off with that. I had a couple things I wanted to say, but I want to close on that. And what I want to say is now is more than ever, we need instruction for our elders, the elder women and the elder men, to teach the next generation that's coming up. Do not be afraid to pass them the torch. But when you pass it to them, don't pass it in condemnation. Pass it in instruction because you believe that they're going to be greater than you and they are successors to whatever legacy that you leave behind. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let's keep it going.